So here's a question for you. Are we cleaning our skin too much, using too many products? How would you feel if someone told you to stop using soap? Here to answer these questions, yeah, we've got dermatologist Dr. Sandy Skotnicki. Say stop using soap, people are alert. Like, soap? That's right. What we rely on. But you've actually created this book, Beyond Soap, where you talk a little bit about how to get a beautiful, healthy glow. And some of the things, some of the tips are about sort of staying away from soap. So why don't we start with some of the common things that we're doing wrong when it comes to our skin?
Well, part of the reason I wrote this book is, I've been a dermatologist for 20 years, and we are seeing this huge increase of patients coming to our offices with reactions to personal care products. And there's this sort of disconnect about health and washing. So one of the things that people do wrong is they wash too much because they think it will keep them healthy. And it does to a certain extent. Washing your hands and sanitizing your hands is very important to not transmit disease. But the rest of it, we need a less is more approach. I mean, take Meghan Markle, for example. She's like a perfect example of what it means to be less is more. And I think that's what this book is about. It's trying to get people to just tailor it back.
So we're washing too much? By washing too much, do you mean like we're taking too many showers, or are we putting too much gunk on our bodies after the shower?
Both. So what I try to do in this book is make it, there's a lot of hard science in there, but I make it very simple. Okay. So I don't think most people would understand what water and soap does to your skin. Okay. You think it's healthy. But what you have to imagine your skin like a brick wall.
Yeah.
And the mortar of the wall is your natural oils. And water and soap remove it. And detergents to a lesser extent. So do you need or do you want to remove your skin's natural defenses, which is what you're doing when you're using soap and water? Mm-hmm. And the answer is no. And what we realize in pre-antibiotic era, it saved lives. It was necessary. Your great-grandmother showered once a week. She did fine. I would argue she was probably healthier. Furthermore to the, is it necessary, is it actually caused disease? And that's the other part of this book. It has caused disease.
What, you mean like taking away our natural oils makes us more susceptible to disease?
Well, 2 weeks ago in the Annals of Immunology, they published a paper that your skin barrier, which is that brick wall, is associated with, the dysfunction of it is associated with peanut allergy. So it's not just about, you know, because people feel gross if they don't shower.
Yeah.
And part of that is advertising, it's a social norm.
Yeah.
What I'm trying to get across with the book is it necessary for health? Furthermore, has it caused disease?
Mm-hmm.
And then there's the other part of the book, which is just this over product use. I mean, my interest is allergy, and I see, I'll give you a case. Last week, I saw a woman named Beth. Mm-hmm. She'd had a burning, red, itchy face for months.
Mm-hmm.
She'd seen countless dermatologists. She'd tried multiple products. Mm-hmm. And what people do when they have a reaction is they just go get another product.
Right.
Or they get something that says hypoallergenic or sensitive skin, which is not regulated. You can't count on it as a consumer.
Yeah.
So I said to her, in my book I have this, I call it a product elimination diet. It's a play on words because it's not about food.
Yeah.
It's about taking all your products away. I give you a subscribed list of products that I've vetted that are actually hypoallergenic and for sensitive or reactive skin.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like a reset. So you reset your skin. She came back again. She said, well, then you stop and then you have to reintroduce your products. And she said, I figured it out. Or you figured it out, Dr. Skotnicki. It was my frankincense oil. So I cleared up in 2 weeks, and then I used it, and it came back.
So final question for you. My natural oil smell. So what would you say I should use if I'm not using soap? Like, what do you suggest as a replacement?
You use a synthetic detergent,
so
or cleansers that are not traditional soap, and you only wash your bits, groin and underarms.
Okay.
And I would even argue
wash
groin.
The peas. That's what we used
wash
to call it growing up.
Wash the peas.
Wash the peas.